Can we all stand for the Angelus?
The angel of the Lord declared to Mary,
and she conceived of the Holy Spirit.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Behold, the handmaid of the Lord.
Be it done unto me according to thy word.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
And the Word was made flesh,
and dwelt among us.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Pray for us, O Holy Mother of God,
that we may be made worthy of the promises of Christ.
Let us pray. Pour forth, we beseech thee, O Lord, thy grace into our hearts, that we, to whom the incarnation of Christ, thy Son, was made known by the message of an angel, may by his passion and cross be brought to the glory of his resurrection, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Maria, 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 Ma Let us pray in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you. We celebrate today the 15th Sunday in ordinary time, and we prepare ourselves to celebrate these sacred mysteries by calling to mind our sins and asking for the Lord's pardon and healing. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do. Therefore, as Blessed Mary, our Virgin, all the angels and saints, and to all may Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and lead us to everlasting life. Let us stand for the Gloria.
Thank you.
So that they may return to the right path. Give all who for the faith they profess are counted Christians the grace to reject whatever is contrary to the name of Christ and strive after all that does it honor. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
The rain makes the earth fruitful. A reading from the book of Isaiah. Thus says the Lord, as the rain and the snow come down from heaven and do not return there, but water the earth, making it bring forth and sprout, giving seed to the sower, and bread to the eater. So shall my word be that goes forth from my mouth. It shall not return to me empty, but it shall accomplish that which I intend, and prosper in the thing for which I sent it. The word of the Lord. The responsorial psalm.
Yeah.
The seed that fell into good soil yielded 100-fold. You visit the earth. You visit the earth, give it water. You fill it with riches. God's ever-flowing river brims over to prepare the grain. The seed that fell into good soil yielded 100-fold. And thus you provide for the earth. You drench its furrows. You level it, soften it with showers. You bless its growth. The seed that fell into good soil yielded 100-fold. You crown the year with your bounty. Abundance flows in your pathways. In pastures of the desert, it flows. The seed that fell into good soil yielded 100-fold. The hills are girded with joy. The meadows clothed with flocks. The valleys are decked with wheat. They shout for joy. Yes, they sing. The seed that fell into good soil yielded 100-fold. All creation is waiting for the revelation of the sons of God. A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Brethren, I consider that the sufferings of this present time are not worth comparing with the glory that is to be revealed to us. For the creation waits with eager longing for the revealing of the sons of God. For the creation was subjected to futility, not of its own will, but by the will of him who subjected it in hope, because the creation itself will be set free from its bondage to decay and obtain the glorious liberty of the children of God. We know that the whole creation has been groaning with labor pains together until now. And not only the creation, but we ourselves, who have the first fruits of the Spirit, groan inwardly as we wait for adoption as sons and redemption of our bodies. The word of the Lord. Alleluia, alleluia. Mbeu ishoko ramwari, mukushi ndi Kristu. Vose vanouya kwaari, vanorarama nokusingaperi. Alleluia.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. On that day, Jesus went out of the house and sat down by the sea. Such large crowds gathered around him that he got into a boat and sat down. And the whole crowd stood along the shore, and he spoke to them at length in parables, saying, a sower went out to sow, and as he sowed, some seed fell on the path. The birds came and ate it up. Some seed fell on rocky ground, where it had little soil. It sprang up at once, because the soil was not deep. And when the sun rose, it was scorched, and it withered for lack of water. Some seed fell among thorns, and the thorns grew up and choked it. But some seed fell on rich soil and produced fruit, 100, 60, or 30-fold. Whoever has ears ought to hear. The disciples approached him and said, "Why do you speak to them in parables?" He said to them in reply, "Because knowledge of the mysteries of the kingdom of heaven has been granted to you. But to them it has not been granted. To anyone who has, more will be given, and he will grow rich. For anyone who has not, even what he has will be taken away. This is why I speak to them in parables, because they look but do not see, and hear but do not listen or understand. Isaiah's prophecy is fulfilled in them, which says, 'You shall indeed hear but not understand. You shall indeed look but never see.' Gross is the heart of these people. They will hardly hear with their ears. They have closed their eyes, lest they see with their eyes, and hear with their ears, and understand with their hearts, and be converted, and I heal them. But blessed are your eyes, because they see, and your ears, because they hear. Amen, I say to you, many prophets and righteous people longed to see what you see, but did not see it, to hear what you hear, but did not hear it. Hear then the parable of the sower. The seed sown on the path is the one who hears the word of the kingdom without understanding it. And the evil one comes and steals away what was sown in his heart. The seed sown on rocky ground is the one who hears the word and receives it at once with joy. But he has no root and lasts only for a time. When some tribulation or persecution comes because of the word, he immediately falls away. The seed sown among thorns is the one who hears the word, but then worldly anxiety and the lure of riches choke the word, and it bears no fruit. But the seed sown on rich soil is the one who hears the word and understands it, who indeed bears fruit and yields 100, 60, or 30-fold. The Gospel of the Lord. Dear brothers and sisters in Christ, our readings today are about the Word of God. They speak about the receptivity that is given to the Word of God. And they also speak of the effectiveness of the Word of God. The first reading tells us about the power that is in the word of God. Like the rain and the snow that falls onto the ground and makes the soil rich and achieves God's purpose, a word spoken by God is never a barren word. It achieves its purpose. Dear brothers and sisters in Christ, I find it interesting that Isaiah writes about the word of God and how it fulfills its prophecy at that dire time. You will remember, dear brothers and sisters, that this passage we read as our first reading is taken from the second book of Isaiah, a book that is written when most of the people in Israel are exiles in Babylon. They are away from their fatherland. Every day they are being mobbed by the Babylonians. The Babylonians brag about the powers of their God. There is no God as great as their God. And hence, they are able to oppress the other nations. And in the midst of that chaos, that period of desperation, of despair, Isaiah proclaims a message of hope. He says to the Israelites, look, listen, hear this. Your God is equally powerful, if not more powerful than their gods. Whatever God said to you will come to fruition. When God made a promise to you, that promise will be fulfilled. Isaiah is telling the people, God has not deserted you. God hears you. And God will act in your midst for your good. It's a daring message of hope, given to a hopeless people. It's a message that is built around the promises God made to Israel's forefathers. And Isaiah says, what God promised us, one day God will fulfill. The gospel is taken from the 13th chapter of Matthew, a chapter dedicated to the seven parables of Jesus. Most people dare not preach on today's gospel, and their excuse is very simple. When the master has preached, we can preach better than him. And yet, should we buy that, we are likely to miss the message. There is still a lot that we can learn from today's gospel. Dear brothers and sisters in Christ, Jesus' seven parables are about the kingdom of God. And it's as it were, Jesus is struggling with a question. Why is it that when he proclaims the kingdom of God, some people accept his message and some people reject his message? And Jesus has a way of communicating what is happening amongst those who are listening to him. He says, the message of the kingdom that he proclaims is like what a sower does. He goes out to the fields and he generously broadcasts the seed. And as he does so, the seed falls on different types of the soil. There is nothing said about the barrenness of the seed. Whether it will yield fruit or not is muchly dependent on the type of the soil that it falls on. And Jesus says, yes, some people listen to me, and yet the message of the kingdom has not taken root in them. And then it gives the various types of soils. By the time Matthew writes his gospel, he has the same problem. He has to try and explain to the people what is happening. Why is it that some Jews are accepting the message of Jesus Christ and some Jews are rejecting it? And Matthew says, like the soil on which the seed is planted, people vary. Dear brothers and sisters in Christ, I think there is a modern parable of the soul. We still ask, like the community of Jesus, like the community of Matthew, why is it that some people hear the word of God, but they do not seem to yield a harvest? Why is it that in a country like ours that is hugely Christian, we live as though we have never heard of the word of God? I think if a modern parable were to be told, it will go like this. The word has been proclaimed, but depending on the people that hear the voice, there are so many things that stand between them and the word. In our country, in Zimbabwe, these days, we speak a lot about corruption, though nothing is being done. Some people hear the word of God, but it's not good for their business. If they were to follow it, their businesses will collapse. Some people hear the good word of God, but it's not politically correct. If they were to heed the word of God, they will have many and political enemies. Some people hear the word of God, but they are so busy in life, spirituality of business. If they were to heed the word of God, them being busy bodies will not know what to do. Some people hear the voice of God, and they try and live by it, and they suffer a lot. Persecution comes their way. Businesses collapse because somehow they try to live a life of integrity. And in such a world, the choices are dire. Do we choose to live by the word of God, or do we choose survival at all costs? Amazadiwa mnamako wenu Yesu Kristo. Zvidzidzo zvedu zvanhasi zvinotaura nezveizvi ramwari. Muchidzidzo chekutanga tanzwa Isaya achitaura kune vana vekuIsraeri vari muBhabhironi. Anzi naIsaya, izvi ramwari rinodzika richibva kudenga rinoita kunge mvura, rinonyororesa pasi roita kuti ivhu ribereke. Izvi ramwari harimbofi rakadzokera kwaari risina kuzadzisa zvarinofanira kuita. Isaya anotaura nezveizvi ramwari kune vana vekuIsraeri vari mukati vekusekwa nekutambudzwa kuBhabhironi. Isaya anoparidza izvi ramwari kuti avape chitarisiro. Kana Isaya achiparidza kuti ape vanhu chitarisiro, chitarisiro chinobva mune zvavakavimbiswa naMwari. Mwari akavimbisa madziteteguru avo kuti hambofi akavasiya. Isaya anoti kune vana vekuIsraeri, iye Mwari akavimbisa madziteteguru enyu anotendeseka, achazadzisa zvaakataura kwamuri. Dama redu rakanaka ranhasi rinotaura kwatiri nezvemukushi wembeu. Paanokusha mbeu yake inodonhera munzvimbo dzakasiyana-siyana dzinofananidzirwa nemwoyo yevanhu. Tinorigamuchira sei izvi ramwari? Zimungwari nosika kwa chiri tichizi neza nekuzi shusha nezuru zwakasia nosia. Zinuwa ndozi nori chanzi isa kutiridzike mizi moyo menu. Zimwezwe zinu zinuwa nikwa mkati menu. Zinori batzira kutiridzike mizi. Asiko zuhuya o zwe upeni zwatino zishusha nezuru. Kana chavu tuwa gacho uvi toka nganwa nezwe yizuru moga mkati menu. Tongo manya o. Kuita zimwezi sina mwari mkati. Kana tadaro, tunoshaya mbereka, mbereko ya kanaka. Nasi uno, tunokurudzirwa na mwari, kutizeye, tizivunze, tizanise fungwa zenu. Kwa hilo izira mwari, ratino nzwazo wa nezo, tinori, rino uira muivu, rakaita zenu. Takazi gazi lira ere, lirarama, takazi gazi lira ere, kutiribe rino titunga miri la mkati. Nasi uno ngatina matei kuna iye mwari mkushi kwembeo. Kutati batzire utili gamchire ni mwoye ruyose ribere kemchiro ya kanaka. Tiko shandura nika. Tiwanyo mambo weneke. Nimuna Kristo mambo wene.
Let us stand and proclaim our faith. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day, in accordance with the scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church, and I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world.
Mambo ya mtuwe ni watakapiwa na mambo wedu anu gara matiri. Ashitibatira kuna macha kuna Kristo nenzira ino mfaza. Agonzo azuchemo zwedu. Mambo Yesu ichaye kutisangano renyu ritunga mirirwe na mwea wenyu. Tinzwe yuo mambo. Tunga mirira ofungwa za watongi venyika zose kutipatongi zunubatira vanu gose. Tinzwe yuo mambo. Inzwa yu kuchambura kwa warombo, nuku wa waka sungwa vose, tinzwe yu mambo. Tizitise yu wano moyo mnyoro, kuna vose wano chambuzika, tinzwe yu mambo. Ngachimbo nyara rai mwene mwe wedu achisa chemo chake kuna mwari. Tinzwe yuo mambo. Mambo Yesu Kristo atikondi kuvimba na mabasa yedu akanaka. Asi tinotarisira kuwana zvose zvatinotembera pamusana pokuti mune tsitsi dzakawanda. Gamuchiraiwo norufare mikumbiro yedu iyi yatati mutitsitsire kuna Mwari Baba. Mambo wedu Yesu Kristu tikuna baba muri yenyu yati mwari baba vedu tambirawo zvipo izvo zvatiri kusuma kwamuri musimbise nazo musimbise chitendero chedu norudo rwedu ndozvatati mutisvitsire kuna mwari baba. Mambo ngave nemi. Ipai mwoyo yenyu kuna mambo ngatitendei mwari. Zvecho kwadi ngatimutendei nokuti ndizvo zvinofanirwa kuitwa ndizvo zvinotisitsawo kuupenyu. Mwari baba nemuna masimba ose nyakugara narini tinokutendai misi yose. Chidoi chingapinde icha makaratidza chokuti tumira mwana wenyu kuzotinunura. Mukamuti akafanane nesu kuzvinhu zvose kusiya chete kupara matadzo sesu vanhu. Zvamaifarira kuona pamwana wenyu uyu ndozvamunofanira kuona patiri izvi. Makatisika mukatipa zvose zvakanaka tikazozvirasa nokutadza kwatakaita. Imi ndokutuma mwanakomana wenyu Yesu Kristu akava munhu akatifira pachipiya nesu kuti tiwanezve zvatakambenge tarasa. Naizvozvo imi Mwari Baba tinokuimbirai misi yose pamwe nengerozi navasande vose tichiti. Musande, musande, musande. Mambo Mwari wamasimba, denga napasi zvizere nembiri yenyu, ngaarumbidzwe ari kumusoro-soro, ngaarumbidzwe samutumwa waMwari, ngaarumbidzwe ari kumusoro-soro. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and giving it thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring it to the fullness of charity. Together with Francis, our Pope, and Robert, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with the Blessed Apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. Mponesi wedu pachake ndiye akatirayira akati tisachinamato ichi kudaro ngatinamatei tichiti. Baba vedu muri kudenga, zita renyu ngarinamata, mambo enyu ngauswike, kurapwe enyu ngakuitwe, pasi munyika, tipewo nhasi mudya wedu wese, mutiregererewo zvatakutadzira, sokuregerera kwatinoita vakatitadzira, musatiregedzera mune zvakaipa. Tinonorewo baba kune zvakaipa zvose, tinzwirewo tsitsi kuti garike murupenyu rwenyu. Mutibatsire nguva dzose kuramba tinzwenga matadzo nokukunda matambudziko. Takatarisira kuya kumuponesi wedu Yesu Kristu, nokuti ndimi mambo. Mambo wedu Yesu Kristu, makati kuna apostori venyu, ndinokusiyirai rugare, rupai rugare rwangu. Regai kuringa matadzo edu, muringe chete chitendero chesangano renyu. Mbe vana varo vose rugare nokugarisana sehama nehama. Imi mwari munogara muchitonga kwemusiisinga here. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb.
Let us pray. Having consumed these gifts, we pray, O Lord, that by our participation in this mystery, its saving effects upon us may grow through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. The Mass is ended. Let us go in the peace of Christ.